Between September 1944 and April 1945, one of the most prolonged and bitter battles of the Second World War was fought between the Western Allies and Nazi Germany. In the battle for the Rhine, Hitler's Wehrmacht mounted a last-ditch defense of the German frontier, intended to cause the Allies major casualties, breaking their resolve and destroying the alliance between Britain and the United States. The battle for the Rhine saw some of the most audacious and dramatic gambles of the whole war. At Arnhem and the Bulge, each side tried to seize the initiative by surprise attack. At the same time, Hitler unleashed a new generation of long-range weapons designed to terrorize Germany's enemies into coming to terms. For the Allies, the push to the Rhine was to be the final assault that would bring a quick and victorious end to the European war. In fact, far from collapsing, the Wehrmacht would fight for every single mile of territory, denying the Allies victory for another 7 long months. On D-Day, June the 6th, 1944, the Western Allies launched the long-awaited invasion of German-occupied France. By the end of the first day's fighting, 150,000 troops were ashore on 5 separate beachheads. The immediate objective was to link up and consolidate before breaking out into the rest of Normandy. On the eastern flank, the British and Canadian divisions made good ground, but were halted at the town of Caen by fierce counterattacks from the German 21st and 12th SS Panzer divisions. A fierce struggle for the bomb-ruined town would rage for more than a month. To the west, American forces raced along the French coast towards the port of Cherbourg. All supplies for the 5 divisions in France still came through the landing beaches, and it was essential to capture a sizable port. The United States First Army reached Cherbourg on the 20th of June and began fighting its way through the tenacious German defense. The street combat was bitter, but after 4 days of relentless American attacks, the last of the Germans finally surrendered. By July the 28th, 1944, after nearly a month of fierce fighting in Normandy, the Allied forces in northwest France had secured an area from Coutances to Caen, the town around which the entire Normandy offensive was to pivot. When the Americans seized Avranches, elements of the newly formed 12th Army Group were able to break out and fan rapidly south. But suddenly it became clear they had bypassed the main German forces, and they were ordered to drive east, pushing all out for the River Seine. South of Caen, British and Canadian forces, struggling against fierce German resistance, were now heading for Falaise. When the town eventually fell, the German 7th Army, aware it was being squeezed in an ever-decreasing pocket by 2 massive Allied army groups, began a desperate retreat. In some of the harshest fighting of the invasion so far, the Allies struggled to close the gap through which the Germans were withdrawing. Finally, on the 20th of August, the pocket snapped shut. and 60,000 Wehrmacht troops were killed or captured. The Allied army groups joined up, and the new broad front advanced eastwards. The city of Paris, the French capital, was believed by the Allied commanders to be defended by a powerful German garrison. The Allies had therefore decided to bypass the city altogether and to continue the main drive east. However, in August 1944, members of the underground French resistance heard that the Allies were rapidly approaching and began to revolt, hoping to overthrow their Nazi oppressors before the Allies arrived. Free French units in the American First Army heard of the Paris uprising and refused to bypass the city. Defying their superiors, they struck out for the capital. The 4th Free French Armored Division fought through the Paris perimeter defenses, and the first tanks entered the city center on the 24th of August. Both the French and the American divisions following behind were greeted by ecstatic crowds, and within a day, the remnants of the German garrison had surrendered. While the Allies had been liberating northern France, a second amphibious invasion had begun assembling in Italian and African ports. The 1st Free French Army and the United States 7th Army planned to invade the south of France and meet up with the main Allied thrust in Normandy. Operation Dragoon began on August the 15th, and by the end of the first day, 94,000 men and 11,000 vehicles had landed on the Côte d'Azur. The main French and American landings for Operation Dragoon took place along the French south coast between Cannes and Cavalaire. The region was lightly defended by the Germans, and the advance was rapid. The great ports of Toulon and Marseille soon fell. The US 7th Army made an attempt to outflank and trap the fleeing German 19th Army at Montélimar, but the Germans escaped. The 7th made a second attempt at Grenoble, but again, the German withdrawal was too rapid. Although the two outflanking attempts had failed, they did force the Germans into an even faster retreat. On September the 12th, 1944, just outside Dijon, the 6th Army Group met up with the right flank of the 12th Army Group, fanning south. The Allies now had a solid front line right through France, opposite the German border. Since the liberation of Paris, the Allied spearheads had continued the main advance towards Germany. In early September,